All right, so that is a raise, and this is a pretty good use case. If you want to basically just combine or group certain information together in one variable in a list, that's when you use arrays. Now, let's say we want to have kind of an object that can have different values and different keys. So we can say the object's name is Nick, the age is whatever, and then the hobbies, like that. And how we're going to do that is, let me actually drag this over to that tab right there. There we go. How we're going to do that is we're basically just going to, I think I forgot to do something actually. Oh, I was just going to finish up the, okay, before we get into objects, I apologize about that. We're going to get into interacting more with the web page first. So I'm going to jump up here, and I meant to do this a few videos ago, and then I got sidetracked by the arrays. So at least we know how to do arrays now. I'm going to create an input with the class of my input. I'm going to close it, and I'm going to skip down a line. Using the br element. Save it and refresh. There we go. So what I want to happen here is I'm going to type in something into the input, and then I'm going to get the button, and when we click the button, what we're going to do is we're going to change this text to basically whatever I type into the input. So in this case, we're learning how to interact by grabbing a value. And then setting the inner HTML of an item. So when this button clicks, we don't want to do any of this. Well, let's leave the button clicked there. What we're going to do is we're going to first get this element by the class. So it's my input. So document.getElementsByClassName. And then the class name is my dash input. And that line right there. So this is going to get that element. Now what we can do is we can then get that value. So we need to store this in a variable. So let's create a variable called custom text. And then we're going to get the value of that by, actually, let's do that right here. No, okay, just wait. What we're going to do is we're going to set this HTML for the ID of text. So var results equals document dot get element by ID. And it's going to be text. And then what we're going to do is we're going to say results dot inner HTML. And this is a variable that we're setting, so go equals, and then we're going to basically access whatever was typed into the input, which it's stored in the variable custom text. So this is the input field there. So what we need to do is type current, or sorry, custom text dot value, and then semicolon. So let's save this, and I'm going to refresh the application here. I'm going to type hello world, then hit go. It says undefined. So let's open up the console there. I'm pretty sure I missed something. Text is not defined. All right. Let's console log custom text and find out exactly what I am. Oh, you know what it is? This is going to give us back a list of all elements with the class. So as you can see, it's a list here, and this one right here is at index 0. So we're getting all the elements, and it's returning as an array. So what we need to do is we need to target the first index in that array. So I'm going to refresh here, and I'm going to type something here, just gibberish. And when we hit go, it's going to grab that value. And then it's going to set it right here. Now we can go a step further. We can concatenate this to make it a little more involved. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the placeholder so that people know what to type in. It's going to be your name. And then what we're going to do here is we're going to set the HTML of results to hello, and then their name. So I'm going to save this, and then I'm going to refresh. So I'm going to say, my name is Nick. When we hit go, it says, hello, Nick. So that's how to grab a value from an input, and it also works on select elements and checkboxes, and as far as text areas, which we actually haven't talked about, so let's go ahead and talk about that right quick as well. I'm going to drop down here and create a text area. This is basically like a large input field for text, except it's multi-line and it follows some different rules. So as a text area, it's not like the input area in the sense that it self-closes. So I'm going to add a placeholder here. I'm going to type your message. And it closes like this. So if I save this and refresh it, we see the text area there. Now what happens if you put text between the text areas, between the opening and closing tag, is that content is pre-filled. Just so you guys know. How you do that with an input field is you just set the value property. So in this case, I'm going to set the value to Nick, save it, and refresh, and we get Nick pre-filled into that input. And these are things that we're going to get more into after as well. I'm trying to show you guys basic usages before we start building projects, and then once we start doing that, we're going to really expand on all the basic stuff that we learn here right now. So I'm going to give the text area a class of my text area. And in the style sheet, I'm going to style it the same as my input. So my text area. So again, what this means basically is both of these elements are going to have these styles. I'm not sure if I explained that before. Oh, yes, I did. Okay, cool. I must have explained that here, I think. All right, so let's go ahead and refresh in there. Now we've got your name, your message. And this is resizable. There's a CSS property for this called resize, and we can choose either a direction or none. So I'm going to set resize to none. Save, refresh. Now you see that this is not resizable. All right, so what we need to do is we need to jump back to our JavaScript here. And instead of saying hello, what we're going to do is... Actually, that's okay. All right, so let's go ahead and let's get the results of the text area. So of our text area, it's going to be equal to document.get. Elements by class name, my text area. And then what I'm going to do down here, I'm going to start spacing these properly. I'm going to set, add a line break onto this actually. So just a regular line break. You can write HTML code within text or within a string of JavaScript, by the way. It's definitely possible. So we're going to skip a line, and then we're going to say results.innerHTML is going to be plus equal message, and then text area, which is our variable. It's going to be a list that returns with all elements with the class my text area. So we're going to target number 0 because we know that's what we need. One sec. All right. And then the value in here is just text. So I'm going to save it. We're going to refresh. I'm going to say Nick, and then my message is I like programming, and then I'm going to hit go, and we've got undefined again. So let's go ahead and console, let's log out the text area. Save it and refresh, and I'm going to type Nick. Oh, whoops, there we go. So we do have this, it's stored there. We could get the HTML of it. She's getting the placeholder. Da, 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 da. It's getting the text length, text content. Tag name, where is this? Oh, it is the value. Okay, sorry. Did I say text? Okay, no. Okay, so text is for elements, like for a div or a span. Inputs and text areas always use value because it's a value that you're setting. There we go. So as you can see, we can get the value of text areas, inputs, checkboxes, whatever you want to grab. That's how you can get that. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say document.get element by ID, and I'm going to get the go button. I'm going to show you guys what I mean. I'm going to set it to B. So B text, sorry, B inner text, it's going to say go. So this is very similar to inner HTML, which I was discussing before. The only difference is that inner text is literally only going to print out text. If there's any HTML code within an element, and I'm going to show you guys actually right now, and then we'll get on to other stuff. Let me go ahead and put a bunch of content in here. So I'm going to put a div, hi. And then a comma and a space. Now here I'm going to create a div with a class of unnecessary. And then inside that I'm going to put a span. And I'm going to say world. Now I'm going to save this. I'm going to refresh it. Now the divs cause some line breaks here, obviously. But this is just for demonstration purposes. So var T equals document, get element by ID. We're going to get it by text. And now I'm going to print out T dot inner text, and it's going to print out just the text. And then if I go T dot inner HTML, it's going to print out all of the code that is inside of that element. So that's the main difference. I think with text, I was thinking of a framework specifically that we work with the text variable inside of an object. So I apologize for that. With text areas and inputs, it is always the value that's used to grab the actual value that's inside of that input. So thank you guys for watching. In the next video, I think we're going to start on objects, classes, and a lot of different things. Actually, I think we need to do more on functions. So we need to speak about a few different things regarding a function, which we should do in the next video, and then, some other awesome stuff after that.